going on. You always got to see safeties.
First day of pads for you guys. I mean, there's just obviously a different level of excitement, energy, and competitive spirit that goes on out there. Can you speak on, you know, all those factors as far as how different it is having the pads on compared to just shoulder pads in the helmet?
I mean, it's totally different. Everybody's coming to compete in there. Everybody's trying to get after it. You know, it's totally different. It's big gap. So I mean, I'm really excited about that. I mean, everybody's going 100%, 110%. So I mean, all it is just tighten up the little things, and we'll be great.
How much did you guys learn just based off of, you know, being able to be full contact today compared to what you're able to learn, you know, without the pads?
Oh, it's a lot different. Just your aiming points, just contact. That's the main thing. And then just the speed and all that. Just making sure to finish every play. We got on pads, so you know, you got to bring everything with you. You know, you can't slack up on your foundational skills.
Sure, it's nice to, when you have a lightning warning, to not have to go. Charlie's saying, last year you had to go into the locker room, sit for 30 minutes, get cold before coming back out. You don't have to do that this year. I guess that's the benefit of having this, huh?
Oh yeah, it's wonderful. I mean, we're in the flow of things, and then lightning strike, we just come in here, it's great. You just keep going, just keep everything moving. Everybody's still warm. We don't got to get cold, and then warm everybody back up, and then that reduces the risk of injury. So I mean, I love it. We all, it's always great. Not too much. I think there's just a little bit more energy around this time, just with everything going on, new excitement. So yeah, that's definitely the difference.
Jason, Mac Brown's called you and Aaron Crawford. He thinks you guys are NFL guys in the future. I mean, how is that? Is that giving you more confidence out there? Is that change your mindset at all? When
I mean, I've always had that mindset. So I mean, it feels good. It feels good to have the head man say that. But I mean, it doesn't change my work ethic. I'm always gonna go 110%, whatever I do. And so, I mean, I just kept the same mentality. So it's not that much different.
How do you think the D-line's, you know, kind of coming along compared to spring? How much have you guys improved? And how much more confidence do you have compared to a few months ago?
Yes, sir. I mean, I was out during the spring, so I wasn't able to see as much, but I mean, it's definitely, we've gotten a lot better. Just from going back and watching film from the spring, you can see guys, the young guys are all learning, they're learning their steps, their keys, they're picking everything up, and they're giving 100% effort. So I mean, that's all you can really ask for, and they're soaking everything up. So
who are the guys behind you in Crawford? It seems like there's a lack of experience behind you. I mean, some names or guys that you expect to step up and do well right now?
Oh yeah, definitely Zach Gill. He's definitely come a long way. He's kind of like my protege. But yeah, him, Brant, and then Christian Varner, the new guy, he's definitely going to be a great one.
What do you think about Brant? He's a big player.
Yes, sir. He's really twitchy. He has pretty good skill set. Just got to hone in on the skills, and I think he'll be great.
Is there any concern about lack of depth behind you?
No, sir.
None. All right.